the night kitchen. As fragrant as a child's sleepy sigh when snuggled fast in mother's arms, his thoughts run wild with starlit charms and puffer-bellied dreams of pumpkin pie. Night's kitchen puffs and hisses secret brews of goodnight kisses, spider legs and thyme, of whiskers, nanny goats, and nursery rhyme, and fisher boys adrift in wooden shoes. Long after cook has gone to bed, the kitchen scents sweep by on alit wing. Cinnamon sticks and morning bread and cricket whisperings that bring the tea-born spices from some foreign shore. The chocolate sweet, the nightcap treat, the tiptoed touch of slippered feet that teeter-totter cross the tiled floor. And while the kitchen ghosts float by, I wonder where they go and why they pitter-pat about the hearth like mice. Or if the fire's honeyed glow alights their passage to and fro, or melts them into dew like winter ice. But long before the clock strikes one, the midnight symphony is done, quick as an infant's cry. I draw the covers round my head, unloose the mainsails of my bed, and settle back into my dream of curds and whey, strawberried cream, and smiles from days gone by.
Thank you.